If you're looking for Lexus luxury without spending as much as like an NX or an RX, this Lexus UX might be exactly what you're looking for. Today we've got the 2020 Lexus UX with the F-Sport package and quite a few different options. And today I'm going to show you everything that you get on the outside, the inside, and take it for a test drive and see if this is a good option for you. Now I have already reviewed the UX Hybrid. Check the description below if you want to see that, and I have all sorts of details in that video if you want to see that. The UX starts in the low $30,000 range, but this model with the F-Sport package and luxury package is going to run right over $40,000. Up front, you'll get integrated LED daytime running lights. Those are Lexus's signature lights with LED high and low beams, and our F-Sport model gives us LED fog lights that give us a cornering function. So at night, these headlights do a nice job. The cornering function is fantastic to illuminate going around corners, but the IIHS gave these headlights a poor rating for excessive glare. If you want the best headlights, you've got an option up for the triple beam auto leveling headlights. This F-Sport model gives you a unique F-Sport mesh grille. It does have non-functional vents, but it's got a little bit of a sporty character, especially paired with this red line paint color. And dimensionally, the UX is 177 inches long, so it's smaller than the Lexus NX and definitely smaller than the Lexus RX, although it is not as compact as you may think. On the side body, you'll also see 18-inch wheels here with our F-Sport model and some pretty large fender flares to top it off. You'll also get an F-Sport tuned suspension for a stiffer, sportier suspension. And in the back, you'll kind of have a hatchback design running around the back and this really long, bold LED taillight and kind of a squared off design to finish this out back here. Now, as you take a look at the cargo area for the UX, it's a little more of a hatchback than it is a crossover, but you still get this hands-free liftgate where you can just stick your foot under there as long as you have the key fob with you. This is optional with the F-Sport luxury package. And then once you get back here, this is where it's a little bit of the UX's kryptonite. You get only about 22 cubic feet of space and a really high load floor. You do get a 12-volt power outlet, a couple of hooks, and a couple lights back here, which do help. And then you have to manually fold the seats down, but they do fold down fairly flat to give you some more space, which can be helpful. But the biggest thing is there's no spare tire back here. So if you're looking for a lot of cargo space, this is definitely not your option. You can fit a decent amount of stuff back here, although it's not great. There's also no spare tire. You get run flat tires that you get standard with the vehicle, but no spare tire back here. And if you want, if you're taking something out, you can just swipe your foot under there again and it'll power fold down.
Lexus gives you the smart key system standard. I'm holding the lock button. You got to press and hold it 3 times for a remote start. I like this key fob. It is slim, fits into your pocket well, and has a nice feel to it. So as you can see, the mirrors are power folded because the vehicle is locked. But the way it works is that there's a line on top to lock it, or you slide your hand back there to unlock it, but then the remote start shuts off.
Our model also comes with the entry exit system, to where when you turn the vehicle on, you can set it however you want. You can have the steering wheel move to you and your seat move to a spot. So you have memory settings with your seats, and our F-Sport seats are fairly comfortable. They have perforations in them because they are heated and ventilated, 10-way power adjustable with 2-way lumbar support as well. And overall, I like the seats. They are comfortable. They have good bolstering around them. I like the shaping. The headrest is maybe just a little bit forward, but overall, I've been comfortable in here. Overall, passenger room is not that great because you kind of have a wide center console that I'll show you in a little bit, but at 5'9", I've been comfortable. I just moved my seat all the way down and I have this much room above me, so 6 foot you should be okay. Over 6 foot, you'll have to check it out yourself. The passenger seat gets 8-way power adjustment, but not actually lumbar support, which is disappointing. We also have the optional heated steering wheel, so this is really nice and it is power adjustable, so you have a power tilt and telescoping option. And this also works with your memory settings.
When you look at the rest of the interior of the UX, it is definitely driver inspired with everything facing the driver, and there's better material quality than you'd probably expect considering this is the least expensive Lexus. Now I'm going to make this quick because I have done a full run through of the interior of the UX, but I like how all the material on the upper part of the door is at least a softer material. Then you have a padded armrest, good grab handle, all automatic one-touch windows as well. I like Lexus's steering wheel. This is the F-Sport steering wheel. You have these perforations on the sides of it as well with some sport grips. It's a very comfortable steering wheel to hold on to. And this is their newest design for the steering wheel. There's no cruise control stock here. Everything is laid out across the steering wheel. You'll see on your wiper stock, you also have rain sensing windshield wipers on our particular model. And then this whole setup will vary depending on which UX you get. You'll get a 7 to an 8 inch display. You see on the left, you have a digital display here where you can scroll through driver assist features, your radio, navigation, and some trip computer stuff on here. So it is handy. Lots that you can still see on here, similar to other Lexuses. You can control all this using the steering wheel and even move that ring over to where you can still have your tachometer in the middle, speedometer digital in the middle, and then all that same information in the middle of this display here. Right up above, Lexus also gives you a full color head-up display, which is optional, and it does look nice. It is very clear and easy to use. You even have a tachometer on there, compass, all the information you need. Now, I believe it's the Lexus LC500 that has the sport and normal type drive mode selector right here. But you can select sport, normal, or eco, and we'll go through this in the test drive. And then you have a decent material quality across this entire Lexus. I was expecting some more cheaper materials, piano black, kind of cheap plastics, but it's honestly a lot better than a lot of people would probably think. And then sitting right atop the dash is Lexus's screen. We can get a 7-inch screen standard, but we have the optional 10.3-inch screen with navigation. So this is the audio screen. You use a touchpad to control everything. So you can see all the shortcuts down here. There's a lot of different customization for the vehicle within here as well. You can even see your climate controls. So for example, if I go back to our main screen, you can change what you see on this side. Like if you want your presets here, or we can go over here and kind of like if we want to see economy, you can have a split screen type setup like this as well. So there's some good and some bad with this screen. We also have the optional 8-speaker premium sound system that does sound nice. You don't get the Mark Levinson sound system that you get in other Lexuses though. And this also has Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and Amazon Alexa. And then as we move down, you'll see your stop start button right there. It has a nice feel to it. Even this material running right here looks nice and feels nice. It's almost like a metal metallic type of feel. And same with these volume controls right here. We get dual zone climate control, so you and your passenger can each have your own temperature. Always nice, even in a small vehicle. And you even get a CD player. You don't hardly see that at all. Plus, you can see you've got Sirius XM and HD radio. And then all your seat controls. So you've got ventilated seats, heated steering wheel. And you can have this be automatic. So you can have your seat be automatic, like where it'll automatically ventilate or automatically heat. Same with the heated steering wheel. So you don't even have to mess with those if you don't want. And in your settings up there, you can customize whether the passenger or the driver's side has a hotter or a colder seat normally. Lexus gives you an electronic parking brake, which is tucked back in there. And then below all these controls, you've got wireless charging right here, which is an optional feature. Not really a good storage area, and there's a 12-volt power outlet that pops out right there as well. Otherwise, it's just a little storage nook. And the cup holders are a little bit annoying because they're right in front of your controls. So for example, all my stuff fits here, but depending on how large your bottles are, they cover up the AC controls or your seat controls. So it's a good thing that you have automatic functions. And this is the touchpad I was talking about. Some Lexuses have that little scrolling mouse, some have this touchpad, and then even the new RX gives you a touchscreen, but this one is not a touchscreen. So everything's gotta be controlled with this. You have a map shortcut, menu shortcut, back button, and then I honestly like this. So your hand can kind of rest here. You have a quick tuning knob, radio button where you can just quickly go to radio or media, a little volume knob right there. And then you have a front and back, or like a back and front arrow to seek with those. So those shortcuts definitely help, so you don't have to use that quite so much. Plus you have steering wheel controls. This is your brake hold button, so it'll hold the brake for you if you set that. The armrest is comfortable. It's also really long, and it actually folds up one way and then the other way, but you got two USB ports and an auxiliary port in there, and it's decent size for this size of vehicle. Plus it actually lifts up this way so your passenger can get in there a little easier.
Lexus also gives you a locking, soft opening glove box.
Lexus also gives you an automatic dimming rearview mirror with garage controls. And aside from the automatic dimming rearview mirror, both your side mirrors are automatic dimming as well.
Up above, you get touch-sensitive LED lights on the interior, and then just a standard size moonroof right up above.
Now, visibility out of here is not bad up front at all, but once you get to the back, because of the design, you definitely don't have very good visibility and a really small rear window.
Now, when you get to the back seat of the UX, this is where it is pretty tight, just like the cargo area. So if you're going to be spending all your time in the front and not really doing much back here having passengers, it's probably perfectly fine. But for me and my family, the car seat back here just doesn't work very well. You get a center folding armrest in the middle with a couple of cup holders. And at 5'9", sitting behind where I was sitting, my knees, if I have them in front of me, are pretty much right up against my seat. So it is tight. If you're taller than me and you have adult passengers back here, it's probably going to be pretty tight. But you do get a couple of AC vents and a couple fast charging USB ports. And even though this isn't a sedan, the seats still don't slide forward and backwards or recline. So you're kind of stuck in this position. And one thing to note is that this is just hard touch scratchy plastic up there.
So moving this Lexus UX, most of the time in some luxury vehicles, you at least get a little bit of a bump in power or a little bit of bump in performance, but that's not the case with this UX. It's basically a Toyota Corolla under here. Despite that, it is still a fairly refined powertrain and it is efficient. Under the hood, we've got a 2-liter naturally aspirated 4-cylinder engine with 169 horsepower and 151 pound-feet of torque paired with a 10-speed CVT. So it is a continuous variable transmission, but it simulates a 10-speed transmission. And we'll talk about that in the test drive. It's a little more torquey, a little more on demand than a typical geared transmission. Miles per gallon is pretty good, but it is only front wheel drive. There's no all wheel drive option. You'll get 29 mpg city, 37 highway, and 33 combined. All right, y'all, we are getting going in this 2020 Lexus UX. So in this test drive, I'm going to give you an idea of what it's like to daily drive this Lexus, the ride comfort, the handling, some of the acceleration. And before we get going, I have started doing kind of a highway MPG test just on my way home from work, where I'm going to do every vehicle that I can from the same spot to the same spot starting and ending on my way home from work. And with this, the speed ranges from 70 to 55, going through a couple little towns, and we got right around its EPA estimate. My first impression of the UX is that it still feels like it has a nice solid build to it. So with Lexus, I'll talk a bit more about the noise in a second, but there's no vibration or harshness really, like there's not any disruption in here in terms of that. But let's go ahead and get on it just a bit. All right, so this is by far no means not a quick vehicle. In fact, the hybrid model is actually a little bit quicker. With that being said, this is sufficient. It's perfectly fine for pretty much everybody that's going to be shopping for this. There's really not too much trouble getting up to speed on the interstate. I would just, kind of like I talked about when I was talking about the engine, was I would like to see maybe just a slight little power bump just because it's got a Lexus badge. But still, I like this powertrain. This transmission is kind of unique because it's a CVT, continuous variable transmission, but it behaves a little bit differently. It does mimic some shifts, or actually make some shifts, where the tachometer does move like you are shifting. And I'm gonna go ahead and get on it again. And it held its RPMs quite a bit there, so it's not like it just shifted up to the next gear, but it does behave kind of different sometimes. But it is responsive. It doesn't, you don't have to really get on it in order to get this car moving. And in terms of the handling, I really like the way that the steering feels. It's not a lightweight steering, it's not heavy, it's kind of right in the middle, and it's a comfortable amount of weight to daily drive with. In terms of driving this around town, that is the absolute best part about driving this. It's got a very tight turning radius, so you can just zoom into some parking spots no problem. And it's just kind of a joy to drive in traffic because of how small it is.
One benefit is that you have the Toyota Safety Sense, or the Lexus Safety Sense. So you've got the adaptive cruise control, you've got the lane keeping system. It will even steer for you if you want it to an extent. It's not the best lane keeping system compared to some other brands, but it does still does a nice job. Now I'm gonna go ahead and put it in sport mode for just a bit as we get around here. I wish this had some all-wheel drive available, but it is only front-wheel drive. So if I get on it, and it shifted right there, as you can tell. Now I'm gonna put the active sound control on, see if you can hear a difference. On, off, there's a little bit more of a roar, but as we go around this corner, the Lexus handles well. With the new platform for these Lexus and Toyota vehicles, they just handle very well. They drive so nice, they're pleasant to be in, there's minimal body lean, and they're just comfortable to hang on to. I've kept the active sound control off because this is not a sporty vehicle. It's not really meant to be sporty. It's just an appearance package more than anything with the F Sport. I like the seats in here. I like the steering wheel. It is also heated. That's part of the F Sport package. I like the ergonomics in here for the most part. I like the layout. I like the quality of materials around me. I just don't like where the bottle holders are. But otherwise, I mean, it's a pleasant car to live with and be in for the most part. It is a little bit compact. My leg does kind of find its way over here sometimes, but overall, it does a nice job. Now I'm going to turn the cruise on and the lane keeping system. So the steering assist, it told me in my head-up display that it recognizes the lanes and that we're locked in. And it's steering for me right now. Now, boys and girls, make sure you keep both hands on the wheel at home. But it's doing it for me, and it's going to tell me to hang on. If I kind of veer over, it corrects and drifts me back into my lane. Now, in terms of the actual steering assist, I seem to fight with it a little bit when I have it on, so I often turn that off, but it has worked well for the most part, and I think a lot of you will be happy that it's standard on every UX model, but you can turn it off if you want. And as we get on the brakes, it has a nice feel. It certainly feels like a light car. It's not super light, but it feels like an easy vehicle to get stopped. Now, as we get going, we're gonna get on a rougher textured road. And right when I was taking off, there was actually a little bit of a shudder in the transmission at low speed sometimes. I have noticed that. Most time it's been smooth, but we are on a rougher textured road, and this UX does not have laminated glass over here. This is pretty thin glass, actually. And as you can probably tell, on a surface where it's not the most smooth surface, you get quite a bit of road noise in here. More than you should get for any vehicle that has a Lexus badge on it. I don't care if it's the lowest trim, people still pay a premium for this over mainstream brands. And mainstream brand vehicles are quieter than this in many cases. So I would expect Lexus to shore this up, give us laminated glass over here, at least at this price point. So that's a little bit of a bummer. I believe one of the UXs, there's a certain package where I think the windshield is laminated acoustic, but I'm not sure about this, but it really should be. So complain about road noise, that's probably my biggest thing. At highway speeds, there is a little bit of wind noise, like on the interstate, but it's definitely not as bad on there. Well, let's go ahead and wrap things up on this UX. So to wrap things up on this 2020 Lexus UX, there's still a lot to like about this vehicle. It's the smallest and least expensive Lexus that you can get into. You've got some of the luxury features on the inside. You've got Lexus's design up front. And overall, I think it's awesome that Lexus still puts a decent build quality and features inside of this small of a vehicle. Now, it is not completely loaded like you can get with, for example, the Lexus RX. You don't have real leather in here either, and it's pretty tight in terms of space. If it was my money, I would honestly go for just a loaded RAV4. But let me know what you think down below. It's pretty cool that you can get this in a hybrid version as well. I just wish this gas could give you all-wheel drive. But thank you so much for watching. Be sure to watch some of these videos down below, and have a great rest of your day.